food out, start working for some food, and then you'll be all set. Stay. Stay. Nord, come. Good. All right, so we got a dog that stays. He'll stay for pressure. I want to teach you guys how he's going to stay, or how he was taught to stay, for praise or reward. So I tell him to stay. I go away. I come right back. Around in a circle. I come right back. I put some food on the floor. Right back. I'm paying him to be steady, okay? Sit. If he gets up, I tell him what he should have been doing. Sit. I apply some pressure. This is just a little body pressure. Sometimes I'll tap his butt just to let him know I want the butt to go down. But ultimately, the dog has to be paid for what you like. And if we want him to be steady, we'll have to pay him to be steady. But we've grown some patience with him to stay. His release is okay. Okay. Good boy. Come. And sit. And stay. So, if he knows that he gets paid, he knows the pressure will come if he does not comply, or if he does not wait for his release to get up, and he knows that there's a lot of positivity in it, we can continue to progress his mental maturity and continue to progress his patience. If you think he's about to get up or is getting antsy, I say, stay. Nord, come. Good boy. And the stay, come on. The stay will help with the come when called as well, because if you can get him to stay, you create distance between you and him, but he knows you have a reward for him, then he will stay until he hears his name or until he hears another obedient posture. And so let's talk about that. This is going to be the last little bit on stay, I think. We'll get him to sit and stay. Instead of releasing him, I'm going to tell him what I want. Down. Yes. Okay, come. Good boy. And so that's what I'm saying. You don't always have to release him. You don't always have to release him when you're far away from him. You can always come back and pay him for the steadiness and release him right there. Or you can just ask for another obedient posture, like from a sit to a down, like we just did. You have a little patience and only say it once. He usually complies. I'm not using any pressure on the e-collar here. This is all for fun, okay? You see the mental maturity and the patience he has now. You guys just do a couple of these every once in a while. Every 2-3 days, you ask him to do something that's a bit challenging, but for food or retrieving. He went and got his retrieve because he loves his retrieve, and I'm going to send you guys home with this. Then you'll be able to keep everything up, and it's going to be very positive. It's going to be very fun to work with your puppy dog. So thank you guys again for tuning in. I'll see you guys on the next video.